in this problem, we're going to build the part of our JavaScript parser that handles JavaScript expressions. This is pretty straightforward, just like the last problem, where we're essentially enumerating all the rules that we've predefined for our JavaScript language. So let's go right to the IDE. So here we have the supplied code for the problem. And if we look closely, we see that almost all the parse rules are enumerated to exactly what they should be. We have identifier, numbers, strings, true and false, how to handle a not keyword, do the opposite, and then parentheses for expressions. We're also given an enumeration of the precedence and the associativity for each of these operations. So really, we have everything we need in the problem description to do this problem. And as you can see here, I've already filled in the precedence ordering for the operations. And this is simply taken almost exactly right from the comment given in the problem, where or is listed at the lowest precedence, and we go all the way up to division right here. I've also added not just to make it work. So let's start filling in the rules. My first rule is going to handle parentheses. If we have a matching left and right parenthesis, the expression that is equal to is simply the contents of the parentheses. Pretty straightforward. And now I have four rules for some of our literal values. We have a number, we're going to say number, and then the contents of that. String, just simply say the word string. If we've matched true or false, we're going to return the specified tuples. If we see a not, then we simply have in our parse tree the word not, and then the contents that are being negated. Now afterwards, we have about a dozen or so binary rules. Addition, subtraction, times, modulus, division, etc., etc. And to save some time, I could enumerate each function, but I'm going to take a shortcut. So here, I've said if we match any of these things, I'm calling it a binary operation, where the first element is the left operand of the binary operation. The next entry in our tuple is going to be the operation being used, and the last one is going to be the right operand of the binary operation. And now I have the expressions for function calls, not just declarations, which we had in the last problem. A function call is going to be an identifier with optional arguments in between parentheses. And the code for handling optional arguments is almost exactly the same as the code we use to handle optional arguments in the function declaration. In fact, I think it is exactly the same. And with all that, we've done it. It's about 50 lines of code, and we're happy.